In this video, I will show you how to dual boot popular Linux distro Nabara Linux with Windows 11. Now, this guide is one of the safest and easiest ways to set up a dual boot on any PC or laptop without any data loss. Also, at the end of this video, I will show how to remove Nabara Linux safely from the dual boot if in case you don't require it. So do not skip the video or any step and make sure to watch the video until the end to avoid any confusion. For the demonstration, in this video, I will be using my HP Pavilion gaming laptop. The process will be similar for any PC or laptop. Now, as you can see, I'm running the latest version of Windows 11. Also, if you notice, my PC has booted with UEFI boot mode. The only requirements of this video, you need Windows 11 or Windows 10 running on your PC or laptop. Next, you need an 8 gigs or higher USB drive to create a bootable disk with Nabara Linux. Lastly, you need to reserve a free space of 50 GB or higher from your existing drive. That being said, it's time to create a free space for Nabara. To do so, open the search bar, type disk MGMT, and click on the first option to open a disk manager, which shows all of the connected drives along with their partitions. Now, in my case, you can see that one drive is connected. If you notice, drive 0 has 3 partitions. The first one is the EFI partition where the Windows bootloader is present. The second one is the main Windows. And the last one is the recovery partition. I'm going to choose the C drive to shrink the free space for Nabara. In your case, it might be D, E, or F, whatever. Just choose the primary partition and right click on it. Now choose shrink volume and allocate a minimum of 40 GB or more for Nabara. You can type the value in megabytes. In my case, I'm going to allocate 250,000 megabytes, then click on shrink. Now this will create unallocated free space. That's it. Now we have done creating a free space for Nabara Linux. Now open your favorite browser, go to the official website of Nabara Linux and download the latest ISO. I'm going to choose a KDE desktop edition. The next step, head over to this website and download and install the Balena Etcher. Now once it's open, connect your pen drive to the computer, click on flash from a file, and import the Nabara Linux ISO. Then select a target and choose your USB pen drive. Now once it's done, click on flash and wait for some time for the bootable USB with Nabara to be created. Once it's done, it's time to back up Windows 11 boot configuration data before installing Nabara, and this step is very important. Go ahead and open the command prompt with administrative privileges. Then enter the following command to back up the boot configuration. Currently, I'm backing up the BCD to the C drive with the name BCD backup. If anything goes wrong after installing Nabara, this backup will help restore your Windows 11 to its normal state. Now, reboot your computer. While it's rebooting, you need to enter into BIOS settings. Use the keyboard shortcut based on your motherboard. Now mostly it could be F2, F9, or Escape key. The first thing to do after entering into BIOS is to enable USB boot. Then change the boot order by setting the USB drive as primary. Now go ahead and disable secure boot, which is very important. Otherwise, Nabara won't boot. And if you have any options like Microsoft's third-party UEFI, go ahead and enable it. It's also better to clear any keys or certificates after disabling the secure boot. Now once it's done, save the changes. The system will boot into Nabara setup from the USB drive. And if in case it fails to boot, use the boot menu to load Nabara install media. Now go ahead and proceed by pressing the enter button to boot into Nabara. Next, continuously press the escape key to interrupt the disk checks. Now, once you are inside the live setup of Nubara, go ahead and connect to the internet. Then choose the system language and region and set the keyboard layout. I'm going to choose English United States. The installer will then present this screen. Under the partition section, make sure the proper drive is selected and click on Replace a Partition. Now you can see the free space is represented with a dark gray color tag. Just go ahead and select the free space using the color tag, and the installer will automatically find the EFI partition of Windows and install the Grub bootloader to this location. Then click on Next. Now go ahead and create a user account and click on Next. Now this is the overview of what will happen once you start the install procedure. Just go ahead and click on Install. Now sit back and relax. The installation will take some time depending on the speed of the drive. Once it's finished, proceed to shut down your computer. After it has turned off, remove the bootable media and then turn your computer back on. Now, as you can see, Nubara Linux has failed to boot and instead your system is booting into Windows 11. Now this issue is caused by the absence of the Grub bootloader. To resolve this problem, open a command prompt with administrator privileges, then type the disk part. Now type list disk. This will show all of the connected drives to the PC. In my case, I have only one drive is connected where Windows and Linux bootable files are installed. I'm going to select this drive by typing this command. Then type list partition to list out all of the partitions on this drive. You might see 3+ partitions. Look for the system partition or EFI partition. Now mostly it's the first partition. Now select this partition by typing this command. Once it's selected, type assign letter is equals to R to mount this partition temporarily. Now type exit to quit the disk part prompt. Now type R colon, this will change the directory. Now here type dir to list the contents of that partition. Then change the directory into EFI by typing this command. If I type dir, this will list the contents of the EFI folder. Now here you can see Nubara and Windows boot files. You will see a folder named Fedora, cd into Fedora and type dir to list its contents. Now look for a file called grub.x64.efi. You will need to use this file and set its path in the boot configuration by typing this command. That's it. Now restart your Windows 11 computer. Now you can see the Grub boot menu. Now using the Grub menu, you can boot into Nubara or Windows 11. For now, let's just boot into Nubara. Now, as you can see, Nubara Linux looks fantastic and working pretty well. This is how you properly dual boot Nubara and Windows 11 on the same drive. As a bonus part of the video, if in case you don't like Nubara and decide to uninstall it, then reboot your computer back to Windows 11. Now open the disk manager by typing this command in the search bar. Now next to the C drive, you can see two partitions that were created during the installation of Nubara. Now please go ahead and remove them by selecting the delete option after right-clicking on each one. You will then notice unallocated free space that you can use to expand Windows 11. You go ahead, type cmd and run it as administrator. Then type disk part. Now type list disk. Now this will show all of the connected drives to the PC. In my case, I have only one drive connected where Windows 11 and Linux bootable files are installed. I'm going to select this drive by typing this command. Then type list partition to list out all of the partitions on this drive. You might see 3+ partitions. Look for the system partition or EFI partition. Then mostly it's the first partition. Now select this partition by typing this command. Once it's selected, type assign letter is equals to R to mount this partition temporarily. Now type exit to quit the disk part prompt. Now type R colon, this will change the directory. Here type dir to list the contents of that partition. Now within the system directory, you will come across two folders named EFI and system, and as well as one file. To delete the system folder and mock kernel, execute these two commands one after another. Make sure do not touch the EFI folder. Then change the directory into EFI by typing this command. Now if I type dir, this will list the contents of the EFI folder. Now here you can see Nabara and Windows 11 boot files. You will see a folder named Fedora. Just go ahead and delete the Fedora folder by running this command. That's it. Now we have successfully removed Nabara Linux from the dual boot. Now lastly, run this command to restore the Windows 11 boot configuration data. Now restart your computer. It should boot your system directly into Windows 11 and you won't face any grub issues or blue screen of death. Now this is how you properly set up a dual boot on your Windows computer. And that's pretty much it. What do you guys think about it? If you have any questions, do post them in the comment section below and I will try to assist you. Thanks for watching my video. This is KSK Ryle. I will see you in the next one.